Good morning, Burries. It's morning. Look at me, getting up early. Shoot. So as you can tell by the title of this video, it is an advice video. The first of many. A while back, I asked you guys on Facebook to ask me some questions or some stuff that you guys want advice on, and I am choosing this one. Surviving college and figuring out what to do with your life. I'm not gonna touch so much on surviving college, but I am going to touch on what to do with your life. Because this is such a crazy question. I think from the moment we start going to school, it's something that we're constantly thinking about. When I was in kindergarten, I was asked, what do you wanna do when you grow up? And I'm like, oh shoot, I don't know, I'm in kindergarten. It's like, I guess I wanna be a mom, cause you know, my mom's cool, that'd be fun. Then everyone else in the classroom were coming up with all these amazing answers. Like, I wanna be a teacher, I wanna be a firefighter, I wanna be a popo. And I'm just like, shoot, how are these kids thinking of these things? So then like my idea of what I wanted to be when I grew up changed because of what everyone else was saying, and it kind of made me feel a little insecure. I was like, okay, well maybe I'm setting the bar too low, or maybe I'm just not even like thinking beyond what's in front of me. So when I got into second grade, I'm like, easy, I wanna be a Power Ranger. That didn't earn me much respect either. Everyone thought I was crazy. Although it was a realistic thing to want, all I watched was Power Rangers. When I got into sixth grade, people started getting really serious about knowing what they wanted to do with their life, who they wanted to be when they grew up, and what college they were going to. This was insane to me because I hated school. I wanted to just finish high school and never have to think about it again. But when I was in school, they basically drilled college into your brain. If you didn't go to college, you weren't gonna do anything with your life, which was kind of scary and just like, ugh, I don't wanna go to more school. I mean, school's not for everyone. I seriously believe that. But I'm not saying drop out of school. You need your education. Everyone learns differently, so it's kind of confusing for me to understand why we would teach everyone the same way and expect, you know, great results. Anyways, back to sixth grade. When I was in sixth grade, people were like, oh, I wanna be a doctor, I wanna be an astronaut, I wanna be a veterinarian, I wanna be a pharmacist. And I'm like, what on earth? How are people coming up with these things? And that's when it really started to settle in. Like, I don't wanna be a loser, I don't wanna not do anything with my life. I wanna do something great, I wanna be something important, I wanna look back at my life and be proud of, you know, what I've accomplished. In sixth grade, I had this really cool teacher who super inspired me and encouraged me to challenge myself and really go above and beyond what I'm normally used to in my academics. And that's when I decided, you know what, I wanna be a teacher. I like this feeling that I'm getting from this teacher who's taking time out of her life and out of her day to contribute to my education and to my personal growth. And I'm like, I wanna give that back to someone else. So I decided I'm gonna be a teacher. And that was a more acceptable answer. When I said that, people didn't give me those weird looks anymore, like when I was in second grade and said I wanted to be a Power Ranger. But at the same time, after I said that, I still wasn't like extremely passionate about wanting to be a teacher. And that always confused me because, like, you know, when you're younger, people say you can grow up and you can be whatever you want, you can do whatever you want to do. But that's not true, because there are all these standards and pressures on what you're gonna be when you get older and how that affects your whole entire life. Let's just skip junior high completely because I still wanted to be a teacher and move on to high school. I took a home ec class and I loved it. It was amazing. I love cooking, and the Food Network was added to our cable around this time too, and I just started watching Rachel Ray, Barefoot Contessa, Paula Deen, and I was so inspired by how people can be so creative with food. And I'm like, oh my gosh, this is amazing. I want to be a chef. I love food. I love cooking. I love my home ec class. Why not do this? When I told people what I wanted to do, it was an encouraged idea, but also kind of like, well, why are you changing what you wanted to do? You thought you wanted to be a teacher. And then I kind of started second guessing myself, like, oh yeah, I guess I did make that decision. But can't I change it? This is such a permanent, like, important decision for my life. Does it matter if I change it? It was kind of a weird response because I felt like by changing my decision of what I wanted to do with my life, I received a little bit of uncertainty from the people who I trusted and really cared about when I was talking about my future. It was almost as if I was being, like, faulty and not knowing what I wanted. And the truth was, I didn't. At ninth grade, how are you supposed to know what you want to do? Some people do. Some people know deep down from the very beginning that they're destined to become a doctor or destined to become a teacher or whatever. But that just wasn't me. I'm constantly changing. The things I like, the stuff I love is constantly everywhere. So for me to settle down and like choose one thing that I want to do for the rest of my life, this was a difficult process. So I joined this club in high school called FHA, which means Future Homemakers of America, which is a really funny name. But it concentrated on cooking and like a whole bunch of other really cool things. And I loved it, like sewing and just basically how to be a housewife. And I loved everything about it. It was a lot of fun. I loved being able to be creative, and that was what really encouraged me in wanting to become a chef and pursue culinary school. This was what I said I was going to do throughout high school. I was kind of set on doing this, and this is what I wanted to do. I started talking to more people who were chefs and did that as a living, and I started hearing the negatives and the downsides of being that. Really coming to terms with, you know, I don't know if I like cooking for other people at such a rapid rate. I like cooking for myself, and I love cooking, and I love being creative, but I don't know if I want to own a restaurant and like have to deal with all that stress and pressure of people being demanding or sending their food back or not liking what they ordered or not being able to put enough of my time into making something really amazing. So my dreams of becoming a chef kind of withered away. But now I'm in college trying to figure out what I want to do still. I figured I'll start with general education because no matter what I want to do, at least those classes will transfer over when I go to a different college. I start doing that and I'm reminded that I don't like school. I hate school. This is boring to me and it was like, felt like it was sucking my life. Then I'm like reminded, oh, if you don't do this, you're not going to be somebody. You're not going to have a good life. You're throwing it away. You're not going to be respected. No one will hire you. All these things going through my head and it's just like, gosh, I can't afford all these classes. I had to pay, I went to junior college, but my dad technically made too much money for me to get any type of funding, so I had to pay for all of my classes, all of my books with, you know, my credit cards and my own money that I made, which was really hard on me because my parents couldn't help me out. Although my dad made a lot of money, he still didn't have any money. So education was kind of a difficult thing. While I was in college, I took an art class, which I loved a lot because I got to be creative. And I'm like, oh my gosh, this is amazing. Maybe I want to be an artist. Maybe I want to design things. Maybe I want to do something like that. And then we got to drawing with charcoal, and I really hated it and dropped out of the class. It's kind of funny. Moving on, I made some really big life decisions and decided that, you know, I don't know if I want to do college anymore because I'm wasting money, I'm dropping classes, and I don't have the money to pay for it anyways. So I ended up getting a job working at an air conditioning company, and I worked there. I also worked at a skateboarding shop, and I loved working at the skateboarding shop because I got to put skateboards together all day and just hang out and chill. The air conditioning job was cool because I worked with my aunt and also like I worked with some really cool people who were super funny and it was just a desk job where I just got to do whatever. I spent most of my time organizing files and creating new ways where the office can work more efficiently, and that was really fun. And I was like, well, I like this. Maybe I can be like an office manager. Maybe that's something that I can do. Do I have to go to school for that? I don't know. And then I made a really big life decision and decided to go to Bible college. There was quite a few things going on in my life that helped me make this decision. At that certain point in my life, I really wanted to be a part of something, and the Bible college offered an internship. And it was kind of like a giant family of people who kept you accountable and like challenged you to grow, and I wanted that more than anything. Because everything that I had been doing up until that point was kind of like, it just felt meaningless. Also at that point in my life, I just needed this more than anything. So I start going to Bible college and I learn so much. My internship program, I learned how to work with people. I learned how to delegate. I learned how to dream. I learned how to plan for things. I just learned so many things that I still use to this day. I learned how to mentor people. I learned how to be mentored and accept other people's advice. And I also learned a whole heck of a lot about the Bible, which gave me new perspective and like wisdom on, you know, how I understand life and process those things. Just a random side note, sometimes people read the Bible and just read it for face value and just read what's in front of them, but I think to truly understand the Bible, you need to understand what time it was written in and who it was written to. Random side note, going back to the advice. I did this for about 2 years and it was extremely rewarding but also very, very draining. At the same time, I started making YouTube videos, and that was something that was a breath of fresh air to me. Being able to be creative, having an idea in my head, and then being able to see it turn out in video form was so cool and so rewarding that I was like, man, this is something I really like. I get to be creative. People are watching my videos. I'm starting to make money off of it. Maybe this is something I really want to do. And then Bible college really didn't fit into that. When I talked to people about it, especially the people that I did my internship with, and some of the pastors at the Bible college, following my dreams of pursuing YouTube was very foreign and kind of just not accepted. It seemed like something that wasn't going to turn out in the end, like a crazy dream. And at that time, I think everyone had the right to believe that because YouTube wasn't a career yet for people like it is now. It was just a place where people watch funny cat videos. It kind of still is for some people, but you know, YouTube has really progressed since then. So I came up against a lot of opposition. Like people are like, you know, you need to make up your mind, you need to figure out what you want to do. And I'm just like, well, I like doing this, I like being creative. And then I would think about, you know, Bible college and how I was able to be a mentor and start these really awesome ministries and like be able to help people and how it helped myself. And I'm like, well, I still want to be able to do that, but I don't think I want to do it in a church. Then I really started to question like, what the heck am I doing with my life? I keep changing everything. Finally made the move and I'm like, you know what? I want to do YouTube. I want to do film full time. Maybe I want to be an actor. Maybe I want to be a director, a producer, a writer. I don't know what that involves, but I know that I like doing YouTube and I like the community that's there. I like being able to be creative, I like being around creative people. This is what I want to do. So despite all of the negative response that I got from wanting to do YouTube, I did it anyways. And things didn't get easier. It was actually really hard because YouTube started to become my job. And with that comes all these new pressures of, you know, like my videos have to do well or I'm not gonna have enough money to pay my bills, which I had acquired a lot of debt from, you know, going to junior college and then going to Bible college and all these things that just add up. But very easily, it was the most rewarding thing that I had done in my whole entire life. And I finally felt like I knew what I was doing and I think this is what I want to do. I tell you guys all of this because sometimes thinking about what you want to do with your life can be an overwhelming question, especially when you start comparing yourself to other people. I told you my story because I spent the majority of my life not knowing what I wanted to do, and I still kind of don't. It's always changing, and I think it's important to find things that you like doing and keep working towards them, and it's okay if they change. The one underlying thing that I always liked doing and always inspired me to want to do it, no matter what the job title was of my, you know, choice occupation at the time growing up, it always had something to do with being creative or helping people. And those are the things that I value the most. And that's what makes me feel alive, and that's what makes me feel like I'm doing what's right and I'm serving my purpose. And I think for you guys, figuring out what you want to do with your life could come from the same thing. Figure out what you like doing. Do you like being creative? Do you like writing? Do you like helping people? What is it? What's something that whenever you're doing, you have this peace and you feel awesome when doing it? Like, you know, like, yes, I'm doing something right in the world. Whenever you get that feeling, start trying to do things that can incorporate that emotion or that trait. I love doing art, but I don't think I was meant to be an artist, but I get to do all sorts of different type of artwork in my YouTube stuff. Like, I love making short films. I love working on graphics. I love working on like t-shirt designs. That's really fun for me, but it's not everything that I do. It's a part of what I do. And thankfully, I took those cooking classes and those art classes because it really has helped me in what I'm doing now. Nothing is a waste of time. Anything that you've done, don't worry. It helps you towards your future. When I worked at the skate shop, it helped me be more creative. So, long story short, could answer this question really directly, but I kind of wanted to use my life as an example. You may not ever know what you want to do, and that's okay, but always be doing something, because you never know what that something is going to lead to. When I was in Bible college, I was doing something completely different that had nothing to do with Bible college. And now it's my job and it's my career, and I love every part of it. So you may be working at a fast food restaurant right now, but it could open the doors to something beyond your wildest dreams. Keep doing things that make you happy, regardless of what other people have to say about it. Remember, it is your life, and if people can't see your vision or your dreams, then don't feel bad about it, because there's a reason why only you can see it. Because you're the person that's supposed to make it happen. My whole life I've come up against a lot of opposition where people didn't believe in me, and it's always been a constant struggle of me trying to prove them wrong. And as I've gotten older, I realized it wasn't me trying to prove them wrong, but me showing myself that I can do something beyond what I thought I was capable of. And you can do the same thing. Anywho, I hope that was helpful to you guys. I know it was all over the place. It's just kind of, I learn a certain way where people tell me a story, I learn a little bit better. Good luck on finding out what you want to do, and if you want to be a Power Ranger, no judgment here. I think that's cool. See you guys tomorrow with a brand new video. Bye!